Good morning. It's just after 6 o'clock on the Sunday morning, so 2 days after my last video, and I'm off to shoot another lovely little place that I know that looks great in the autumn. Just averted a disaster there though. While I was waiting in the car, demisting and defrosting, I decided to do this, a little piece to camera, only to find that I'd left my vlogging camera still in the house, so I had to quickly run in for that. Good job I decided to do that. It would have been a very, very annoying thing if I'd got all the way to where I'm going, only to find that I couldn't make a video. Today I'm off to... Actually, I'll show you.
The Falls of Aberfeldy lie just to the south of the village of Aberfeldy in Perthshire. It's an area made famous by Scotland's national bard, Robert Burns, who famously composed a song while visiting the site back in the summer of 1787 while on his tour of the Scottish Highlands.
Okay, hopefully you can hear me above this water. I think I found my first two compositions. Behind me we've got this series of cascades which are... Yeah, we've got this lovely series of cascades which is disappearing up into the kind of darker glen up there. And then if I flip round and look downstream, then you've got some lovely autumnal colours there, and still a little bit of movement in the water. So I'm going to set up and see if we can grab a couple of shots here. Okay, so what I've done here is I've initially I had on my 16-35mm lens, but that was kind of too wide. And I've noticed, I don't know if you'll be able to see this, but there's a little patch of leaves there right in the middle of all this watery chaos. And I've decided I want to try and focus on that and emphasise just that little spot of tranquility in amongst all this. So I've switched over to my 20-40-105 lens. I've zoomed in a little bit and I've put a circular polariser on as well to try and cut down some of those reflections and really bring out those orangey-red colours. Whether it works or not, I'll find out when I get back. But okay, so what I've done here is I've put the 16-35mm lens back on, and I'm kind of shooting across those falls now to try and maximise the detail in the water. And also because I've got a wide angle lens, I can include some of this colour down here as well, as you can see from the back of the camera there. Yeah, I like that, it's nice. Still got some detail in the water. There's a little tiny bit of clip in there. I might reduce the exposure just a little bit. I think I'm at F13, 4 seconds at the moment. So I'll drop back down to 3.2 seconds to see if that retains all the detail. But yeah, I like that, it's a nice shot. And I'm hoping that I might actually take a longer exposure so to ensure that I get some of the detail in that back wall. Because that back wall there is quite interesting as well. So I'm taking a 15 second exposure in order to capture some of that detail. And I'll blend them together in Photoshop when I get back into the onto the computer. I've got a slightly different composition now. I think I'm fully out of the 16mm to really maximise field of view. I've stopped down to F13 and I've still got a 3.2 second exposure, but I don't know if you can see from the back of the camera. What I've got here now is I've managed to get in, there's quite a lot of leaves along the foreground here. So I'm managing to include them and this boulder here and the composition while still retaining the entire waterfall and just a little bit of detail over on the far wall there. What I might do is raise up a little bit so there's a bit less foreground and a bit more of that back wall, because there's some
lovely details over there on that back wall, which I'm missing out on at the moment. Yeah, slightly tweaked composition. What I've done is I've raised the camera up just a little bit so that we're including some more of this background. This is definitely going to be a couple of exposures blended together, because that's quite a dynamic range there. So I'm exposing 4 seconds for the water. Let me just see how that looks. Yeah, that seems okay. So 4 seconds for the water, and then I'm going to take it down again to about 15 seconds for the background. Obviously that's going to result in the water being blown out, but with a bit of luck I can blend those two exposures together to make quite a nice image. So all over the world, especially New Year, everybody sings it. Definitely one of your best. Sorry, I didn't realise you guys were watching. I just having a wee word with Burns here about Auld Lang Syne. That was one of my favourites. That A-phone kiss is pretty good as well. You've done well with that one. But I'll leave you to it. What's that you're writing? Ode to COVID. That'll be a cracker. Right, I'll leave you to that one. I'll go and take some photos here. It's a bit steep. Yeah, what I love about this place is there's just waterfall after waterfall after waterfall. If that's your thing, if you're into shooting waterfalls, then you've got to get yourself along to the Bucks of Aberfeldy, because it's just incredible. Look at this. Probably point out that, according to the song at least, it was actually summertime that Burns was here, or the simmer as he calls it. I don't think I've ever been here any other time than autumn. I really need to get the finger out and start coming to these places a wee bit more frequently, because I'm pretty sure this was looking amazing in the summer. And there's another little waterfall there. I quite like that one actually. Might sit up and get a little shot of that. That's lovely with all the little cascades all tumbling down there. Yeah, sorry, another gratuitous waterfall shot coming up. I was just about to walk away there when I realised there was actually another shot just a little bit. I was over there a second ago, shooting up the way up the burn. But as you walk along to the side, you can actually, you've got this lovely little kind of meander in the burn, and obviously it continues down. So what I've done is set up a composition that's vertical format, if you can see that. And that's vertical format, and I've got the waterfall cascades coming in at one end, kind of meandering through the image, and then down at the bottom. And you've still got some tree there, I've got a wee bit of context. Some of these ferns on the side there. Yeah, I like that, that's very, very nice. Is there a shot there? I don't know. You feel as if there's a shot there, but there's just so much foreground here that I would really need to get down to the water side, I think, to grab an image there, because that all those twigs and leaves and things like that, I think would just distract. Although, that said, they kind of do form a kind of natural frame around the waterfall, don't they? What do you think? Can I go for it? Aye, what the heck, give it a go. Let's see how this works. Yeah, autumn has definitely arrived in Aberfeldy. Oh look, a waterfall! Wasn't expecting that. I may be wrong. I think there's a waterfall coming up. It's just, the place is incredible for this. Wow, look at the scene here. This is actually a spot I've tried to photograph a few times before. I never quite managed it. I've managed to photograph it, but I've never quite managed to get an image that I was happy with. You've got this little piece of really still water, and then these little cascades here. And you probably can't see just yet, but just through the gap there, there's quite a significant waterfall that's dropping down from where I think is the spot where Bung's actually composed this song. So we'll go up to that in a second, but I might have another go at getting an image here. Yeah, made it. So, pressure's on me now to actually deliver a photograph there. It's lovely. Right, I've come just a little bit further down from where I attempted to break my neck. I kind of like this, there's a little drop here. I don't know why, for some reason it's just caught my eye. Yeah, I like this spot, it's lovely. So what I've done here is I'm just focusing on that very area there, that little cascade and these leaves. You can probably see it better on the back of the camera. And I'm taking a series of shots. I'm underexposing by about one stop because I think all that white water is confusing the exposure meter. And yeah, it looks fine. Yeah, it's still some clipping up there, but that's okay because I'm going to crop that in a square crop. Yeah, I like that. I like that. I like the detail. Let me just check. Yeah, that's nice and sharp. Yeah, very, very minimalist, very zen, which I think is what I'm going for today. Yeah, I've just noticed there's another really interesting little trickle just at the end there with the leaves above it. So might try and take a close-up shot of that. It's odd, that, very odd. I can see a little, exactly where I focused here, I can see a little cascade there, but the camera just doesn't seem to be picking up. I don't know if maybe I'm at the wrong angle and it's just not catching the light, but that's very odd. That's the very thing I want to photograph, and it's not showing up in any of the images. I might go along a little bit further. I'm kind of close to the water now, so I don't really want to get too close. But I might move along just slightly and see if we can change the angle slightly, and maybe that'll pick it out. I might actually switch over to the telephoto lens as well and really zoom in. That might help. Yeah, I'll try that. Yeah, this is there's a little still area that I was trying to shoot. I love the moss and the trees and stuff like that here. The old roots clinging to the side of the wall, but just trying to catch an image. As I say, I've tried to shoot that several times, pretty much every time I come here, and I don't think I've managed to get something that I'm happy with yet. But and I really don't think I've got one there either. That's an excuse to come back, right? So yeah, we're coming up to the first of the quite serious larger waterfalls. So I'll set up here and get a couple of images. As you can see, it's selfie central at the moment. Try to capture a shot here. I don't think I've ever shot from this angle. Basically just looking back down that kind of still area in the opposite direction. Kind of like these rock formations we've got here. I've still got the telephoto lens in, and that's kind of a bit too tight, so I might stick the 24-105 in, because I really want to include these leaves here and the kind of autumnal colours in the background there. So I'll probably quickly change lens and see if I can capture this. Quick funny story, I think I've mentioned before, my eyesight's not great, and I had the camera set up, and I was trying to compose the image, and the lens kept bouncing back up, and I thought there was something, and I couldn't work out what it was, and I was resting the lens on the fence. I never noticed. Oops. And just over there. Oh, look, a waterfall. Right, I've taken the first shot here, but you know, it looks okay. It's a bit same old, same old. Can't say I'm really happy with that. So what I think my problem is, I've got my 24-105 lens on, and I'm as wide as that'll go. I'm at 24mm, and it's just not capturing. And I kind of like this tree up here. I don't know if you can see that, this tree here. And that kind of adds to the effect. So I think I'm going to try and get a little bit higher and a little bit wider, and see if we can capture more of that. Yeah, that's a lot better. Still a little bit of clipping in the sky, so I'm probably going to have to underexpose that slightly for the sky, and then I'll take a longer exposure for the waterfall. But yeah, even there, it's still clipping slightly in the sky. Let me just. Still, I think I might have to just resign myself to there being just a little hint of blowout on the sky with that. But very nice, eh? So yeah, what I've done is I've switched to the 16-35mm, and I've gone into a vertical crop, a vertical format, and I'm including a lot more of the waterfall now. Still got a bit of sky in there, so I'm having to bracket the exposure slightly, but it's making for a better composition. Yeah, I like it. I think we're going to my little zen moment now and try and pick out some more details and see if we can get some details in the falls. But yeah, onwards and upwards, eh? Yeah, this is that there is the tree that I was trying to shoot from just down the other side. This is the top of the falls now. You see the water disappearing over, and behind me, there we are. That's going to be tricky to get a shot which covers all of that, because I'm on a very narrow bridge and it's starting to get quite busy, so I don't really want to block access for anybody else. In fact, there's two people coming right now. So, I think I'm going to have to try and find it. It's a shame that little dog leg there would have made for quite a nice image, but there's just no way of getting it without blocking access for everybody else. And you don't want to be that kind of person, right? Okay, so I did it. I waited until there was a gap, and rushed out onto the bridge, had my tripod pre-set up, two of the legs nice and short to rest on the side of the bridge, and one at full extension, and took a vertical shot of the fall. Hopefully that works now after all that hassle. I had to wait for about 5-10 minutes until all the other walkers had passed. Right, now climbing up, I think just up here is the spot where Burns is supposed to have composed his song. Yeah, this is it. I've got to confess right here and now that I am a huge Robert Burns fan. Okay, what I've done is I've come back down again. The path has become very, very busy, and I was constantly having to grab shots by setting the tripod up and then, you know, holding people up and then not standing deliver, obviously, but so I decided to call it a day and head back down the way I came. So yeah, sorry, I had to stop because there was more people coming. So I didn't get up to the highest waterfall, but I've been up there plenty of times anyway, and from the crowds that were going up, I think it's probably about 10 in the morning on a Sunday morning, and I just passed three guys with cans of lager and what looked suspiciously like a bottle of whiskey with them. So I think there's going to be a party at the top of the hill today. But I think I got enough there. I think I got some images that I'm going to be quite happy with, hopefully. And you never know, I might still be able to grab another shot on the way back down, because things always look differently, don't they, when you're looking at them from a different angle. So when I was walking up the hill, you're seeing things from one perspective. Walking down, you're seeing it from a completely different way. So I might get another image, we'll see. Come on in. The feeling it's kind of got this for the rest of the day. So I've had my fun, time to let everybody else have theirs. What this place really, really needs is another waterfall. Well, I'm just about back at Rabbi, and then just after that I'm not too far from the car park. So just take this chance to thank you for watching. Hope you watched to the end. As always, if there's anything in particular you think I could do better, or anything you'd like to see me do, I know I don't really do enough work in the way of explaining how I edit images, so I'm trying to include a wee bit more about how I compose them and the sort of things I look for in an image, but I don't really touch on things like why I'm selecting a particular lens, really, or shutter speed and all that sort of stuff. So if you'd like to see some of that, how I edit, let me know. Just passed another 20 people going up. It's going to be very busy up the top there. Hope you liked the video. If you did, you know what to do. Give me a wee like, give a subscribe. Helps the channel, helps my ego. Thanks to everybody that subscribed recently. I think I picked up about 7 or 8 subscribers in the last couple of days, which, you know, to the big channels is nothing, right? But to me, it's a wee encouragement to continue doing this. Wanted poster.